Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can call any REST API for Power BI using PowerShell. It's a lot of powers. Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, I've talked about using the PowerShell commandlets for Power BI in a couple of different spots, but what I've not done is necessarily focus on the magic of the Power BI PowerShell commandlets. The magic here is the ability to call any of the Power BI REST APIs using the commandlets themselves. That's a lot of stuff. So let me break this down a little bit. A REST API is really just a programmatic way of calling something from a web interface, right? So this is a web URL that you will have that calls a service out there on the internet, and it will perform some action. Typically, when you call a given API, a REST API, you will have to use a certain web method to call it. So typically, you're going to see something like get or post. Get basically means you're just going to read something. Post actually means that you're going to write something. So you're performing some action. You can use a combination of these. There's others as well. And when you look at a REST API itself, it'll tell you what the method is for that REST API. All right. While this is talking, let's head over to my machine and actually take a look at what's available for us. So I've got links down in the description below, but basically this is the REST API reference documentation. So we can see here over on the left-hand side, these are all the areas for which there are REST APIs. So if I expand data sets, you're gonna see that I've got each one of these as a different REST API that I can call. So for example, I can get a list of data sets. Anywhere where you see group, it means an app workspace inside of Power BI. If you don't see group, that means it's going against your my workspace. And when I click on one of these, you will see some common information across all of these. So the first is what this API actually is, right? So this is the URL I would call. It has some parameters, and you'll see these for URI parameters, dataset ID, and group ID. Again, group ID, this is the app workspace, not your my workspace. The other thing you'll see here is the method that it's called. Remember, I said get or post, or some places you'll see patch. So this gives you the information we need to actually call it. For get, it's pretty straightforward. We just call this API and we get some information back. For others, this is the ability to refresh a data set, and you'll see that it's a post command. Sometimes posts have what's referred to as a message body. So this is additional information that you send to that API in addition to the URI parameters that are in the URL. So this is typically a JSON type text blob that you will send as part of the request. Let's actually try and refresh a data set. We've got our URL, and there are two pieces of information that I need. I need the dataset ID and I need the group ID. You can either call APIs for this, or we can actually get this from Power BI itself. So I'm inside of a workspace. You'll see the workspace ID, so groups, and then this GUID. And if I go to schedule refresh, in here we will see data sets and then the GUID as well. We're gonna call this REST API, but how do we do that? This is where PowerShell comes in. The Power BI PowerShell commandlets has a command that's part of it where we can invoke a Power BI REST API as part of it. That's bananas. That means I can call anything. It avoids you having to write all of this extra code. Before we had this, you actually had to wire up C# code, Java code, or something like that to actually call the REST API. You could do it with PowerShell before as well, but you had to wire up all of the actual application registrations, additional authentication pieces. Power BI PowerShell commandlet just takes care of all that for you. So let's take a look. So if I go to the Power BI PowerShell commandlet reference, inside of profile, you will see this invoke Power BI REST method. This is the magic. So we give it the URL, we give it the method. Those are the two required fields, and then everything else is optional. We can just call given items and it will go ahead and do things. So we're going to go back and we're going to call this refresh data set. All right, so there's a couple things going on here. First off, remember I said if we're doing a post, which this is, there is a body. So I have to pass it this notify option, mail on failure. And then I give it the URL. I've supplied my workspace ID and my data set ID, and I'm calling slash refreshes. The method is post, and then I'm passing my body variable, which is this JSON text blob or whatever you want to call it. And then this will actually refresh the data set. This is great. I got an error. I need to log in first. So let's go ahead and log in. Let me clear the screen, paste it again, and we will hit that. And you didn't get any message. That's because all it's doing is triggering the refresh in the service. So there's no response that you're going to get from this. It went and did its thing. If you didn't get an error, You can verify this by going to the Power BI service, and you can see here we've got Mr. Spinny. It is actually refreshing and it just finished. Another command I'll show you that we can call is getting the refresh history. There's no actual command in the Power BI PowerShell commandlets to get the refresh history or to even trigger the refresh. Those just aren't options. That's why I'm using this REST API command to actually do that. So it gives me flexibility to go beyond what's actually defined in the PowerShell commandlets itself. Let's go take a look and see what the refresh history looks like. So this is a get command, and we're just going to go get the list of the refresh history. And you can optionally say how many items you want on top. So again, it takes the group ID and the dataset ID. All right, we're calling refreshes with the get command, and we're going to say, just give us the top 10. What this returns is JSON. This JSON could be converted to do whatever you want to parse that. And we can see here that this last request was via the API. It completed successfully. So you can see I've done a few of these via APIs. I did an on-demand refresh. I did a refresh with an XMLA endpoint and then a bunch of on-demands. You could also see scheduled as well if it was scheduled refresh. So we went ahead and got the refresh history. Again, this is more than just data set operations. So in this case for reports, you could call like the export to API to get a PDF. In this case, let's look at actually just getting a list of pages from a report. Again, this is a get command. It takes the workspace ID and now it takes a report ID and then we'll call slash pages. So we're calling this URL. We've got our workspace ID. We've got a report ID. We're calling slash pages and it's a method of get. And this will give you the list of the three report pages in that report and the order of those pages. Flexibility with calling these REST APIs without dealing with all the authentication you saw. I just logged in. You can also optionally log in with a service principal. Be careful with service principals. Not all of the APIs are supported with service principals, namely like some of the admin APIs, although that's getting updated. But this is a great option to automate different items inside of Power BI with ease. So you can supply this in a CI/CD pipeline. Maybe you've got an ETL batch job and you want to call a PowerShell command to trigger the refresh of the Power BI dataset. These are all things you can do. And because of that REST API option, it gives you all of the opportunity to take advantage of Power BI from a programmatic standpoint. All right, I want to hand this over to you. What do you think? Have you been using the REST APIs and having to write code? Did you know about this PowerShell option? Have you used the PowerShell option? Let me know down in the comments below. I want to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.